Hey, this is Paul from Genelec, and we're here at NAMM 2024 at the John Lennon Educational Tour Bus with Brian Rothschild. Brian, how's the show been for you guys?
It's been amazing. It's been a long time in coming. This is our first time back at the NAMM show since before the pandemic. We spent a lot of time building out this new studio with Dolby Atmos, featuring Genelec loudspeakers, and it's incredible. I mean, we've begun to do Atmos mixes with amazing people, including RZA from Wu-Tang Clan, who will be here today.
And we heard that track. We were able to play it at our booth, and you've been playing it here. It sounds fantastic. I mean, the work can be done in a small space, and that was one of the presentations that you did with the Dolby Institute, who you do work with, that they're part of your tour.
Yeah, that's certainly a very important part of 2024 is our work with Dolby and the Dolby Institute. We began working with them in the fall. We did a tour of historically black colleges and universities. And, you know, thanks to their support, we got this Dolby in a near field environment operating really, really beautifully.
Yeah, and this is really cool. And we want to show the people what you've got going inside. So
should we take you inside
now? Let's have a look.
All right, come on.
Plenty of Genelec on here. I see, you know, this is all the new ones. We have 8341s around us. You have the 8320s upstairs. And this was all, I know we worked together, as well as Dolby, to get this bus to be a Dolby qualified space.
Yeah, this is a 714 room. Genelec has been a partner on the Lennon bus for many, many years now. It's been an incredible cooperation on the technical side and also just in terms of core values, commitment and interest in social justice and training the next generation. You know, the Lennon Bus is dedicated to providing young people with free hands-on opportunities to create music and video and short films. And we enlist the help of a lot of celebrity artists as well. Obviously, it's got John Lennon's name on it. So there's something extra special. There's an extra special sauce that's mixed in, even though it is, as I feel, the greatest nonprofit mobile recording studio in the world.
When you look at it, you kind of get amazed at what it has. But all of the technical abilities to do what you do, it's phenomenal. And just to be able to get this out into places where people might not see this kind of technology.
Yeah, exactly. So as you'll see in a minute, you know, there's a crew of three that live on board here. There are three bunks that are here as well. And the crew members are musicians, they're audio engineers, they're producers, they're educators, and they really inspire. I mean, that's a big, big point of the Lennon Bus. We have students come on board typically and to create an original project in a single day. We've done all sorts of things, but the bread and butter of it over the years has been bringing students on board. They get to know each other in that first hour, share their ideas about music, about videos, about film, things that they are interested in. And then the crew helps them to achieve their goals. But they do it all in a single day. So they write a song, they record the song, they shoot video, and by the end of the day, we've collected all of the assets for that project.
And that, I think, going to what this bus is about, I mean, having real professional gear that is, I mean, this is a well-calibrated, tuned room, state-of-the-art Genelec and other technology in here. So these students, they can be creative and get the work done reliably, which is probably some of the hardest things, right, for most young people as they get started. They don't know what they're working with, and sometimes the technology can be the thing that complicates getting the creativity to move.
Exactly. I mean, when we learned that from a lot of experience in the very early years, this is our 26th year with the Lennon Bus, and it's always been amazing, but the you know, incredible thing about it now is just how the technology is just so much easier and just supports the students and their ideas. There's like, you know, I should knock wood, but there's a, you know, it's usually really smooth sailing. And the other thing I want to say about it is that obviously, you know, Genelec makes a very, very fine product, and people sometimes want to, they're surprised that we're bringing such a high quality studio to students. We go to a lot of underserved communities. We go to a lot of places where they've never seen or most importantly heard anything like this. And a big important part of the bus is providing students with the sense of support that they matter, that we want them to be exposed to the finest that the industry has to offer, because this is something we do a lot with NAM and the NAM Foundation. You know, career path development is a big factor in why we do this, right? We are teaching students about allied fields in music, in entertainment, in live sound, in film and television, things that they often don't realize. They know the star that's in the center of the stage, and that's it. And they come on board and they realize, wow, this is something I'm interested in. This is something that actually is a career that I could pursue. So we're sometimes giving them those first glimpses into how that might work.
I can see that, and it's opening up to that community that is very giving. Like, I don't think that sometimes maybe a young person might realize, you know, because when you're working with all these different manufacturers, there's people behind that are also out there trying to help support and support them. I mean, with the Dolby Institute in here, that's exactly the mission, right?
Exactly, yeah. The neat thing with the Dolby Institute is, you know, in getting to know them, you know, I've, like with all of our partners, always trying to figure out, you know, where we're in alignment, you know, where our values are shared. And increasingly, Dolby Institute, you know, would be just telling me flat out, like, wherever you're going, whatever you're doing, that's where we want to be. That's, we are in alignment. We are interested in making sure that the next generation is inspired and knows about the tools that are available.
And how can you not get inspired in Atmos, like, in, when you're working in a immersive field?
Well, I have to say, you know, obviously it's super hot. Like, people are very excited that we have an Atmos studio. And Atmos is becoming ubiquitous. You know, you can listen to Atmos mixes in binaural headphones now. It's, you know, it's not just for being in high-end experiences. You know, you can actually be in the bus, learn about it, and then go home and be able to continue to work in that way. And that's an amazing, you know, part of it. But, you know, we just finished doing these mixes with RZA from Wu-Tang Clan. He created an original, very beautiful orchestral composition called The Ballet Through Mud. There's nothing hip hop about it, so people are surprised when they hear it.
Yeah, I was surprised when I heard it.
Exactly. And, you know, the first time that I sat in this room and listened to those mixes, I realized this was more than just immersive audio. There was something that's really visceral. I find it really emotional. I kind of teared up a couple times.
How could you not? Like,
yeah, it's very, very beautiful to hear music in this way. Exactly. So I should point out a couple things real quick. We have two rooms, right? The 714 room that we were just standing in, and then there's a 5.1 room back here that we use really for audio recording. This is where we're doing vocals, where we're doing acoustic recordings, which is in the way back room. But the other thing is you can separate these rooms so you can have two things going on at the same time. We use these switchable glass doors that provide sound separation and visual separation. As somebody said yesterday, there's gas in that glass, and I was, yes, that's a good one. There's gas in the glass. So come on back here. That's still a big wow factor, those doors. Another set of those doors here. So this becomes our ISO booth, where we do acoustic recordings. This room, obviously, Roland keys, Roland drums, and this would be, you know, where our young engineers are learning about the DAW that we're working in. We're working in Pro Tools, we're working in Logic, we're working in Reason. Really, we're agnostic in that regard. We want to make sure that, you know, whatever you're used to, you're able to utilize on board the bus here as well. Obviously, these are all the ones as well from Genelec in this room too. And then We have a whole series of Blackmagic design cameras. They're one of
mighty
our
impressive
partners.
Cameras.
Yes, I know. I know. We're really grateful to them. They're, you know, again, their culture, their interest in supporting the next generation is very much in line with the Lennon Bus as well. So they've been a great, great new partner to have involved. You know, the other thing I didn't mention that I should, and that is that we really put in a whole new green, sustainable energy power system.
We
have solar on the roof.
Yeah, really?
Yeah, we have solar on the roof now. We're working with lithium ion batteries that come from our latest partner, Battleborne Batteries, which is a division of Dragonfly. They made a huge commitment to the bus. You know, and it's completely changed the workflow. Previously, our crew members would have to monitor the old lead acid batteries, making sure that, you know, we never went below 50% or else the batteries are destroyed and they're crazy expensive and whatever. This whole system now has revolutionized what we're able to do on the bus, and it's become another teaching point for students who come on board. We're, you know, happy and excited to talk to them about this new system that's on board.
That's fantastic. I mean, obviously, that's an important part of Genelec's, our mission is to, you know, to make sustainable products that efficiency of power and actually the ability to make them sleep or go off. And I know that's an initiative that's working through our entire community. So it's nice to see that you have that upstairs on the bus as well.
Yeah, something we dreamed about for a long time. So when, you know, we just, you know, in doing this renovation, we pretty much ripped out all of the wiring and redid almost everything. And the, you know, the power scenario was something we were super grateful to have the support from Battleborne on. They've been amazing. And I should also mention the whole, you know, studio, the integration of the new studio, particularly the 714 room, was done by Westlake Pro in Burbank. They became a sponsor and they really took on a big job. They didn't know how big it was going to be when they
They weren't quite sure
of how big it was going to be, but when they saw what was necessary, they went the extra mile, and they've done an amazing job here. So I'm often making sure that I tell everybody Westlake Pro did the install of all of this, used all of their resources to make this an extraordinary environment.
Mighty impressive. There's so much to see, and you know, it's a bus, so you're thinking, oh, that's pretty big. When you get in it, you realize you're really trying to pack a ton of stuff into here, and to be able to have these different workflows, utterly amazing.
It's like a sub. There's got to be a place for everything, and everything's in its place.
And then you
last thing is this back room here, another set of these same doors that switch as well, because this is a multi-use space. This is where we would do vocals. This is the ISO booth where we do acoustic recordings. And then obviously this is where the crew sleeps. There's two bunks here on the right. And there's another bunk behind the Genelec name there. That's for whoever the tall person is. That's the tallest bunk that goes horizontally.
Well, you definitely notice it's quieter in here because it's an ISO booth. That's probably makes it a lot better for people that want to sleep.
And if people always want to know, like, is it comfortable in there? It really is. The ventilation is really extraordinary. It is super, super comfortable as they're traveling around because this bus goes all over the US and Canada. There's a professional driver, and you know, this is not just you know, an amazing recording studio. It's also where the crew lives.
Pretty amazing. So you hit the ground running right after the show.
Yes. Yep. We're working on continuing to do college and university dates, historically black colleges and universities. Working with our partners on residencies in Atlanta and New Orleans and New York. So we're excited about what's to come this year.
Well, we look forward to hearing all about it as things unfold throughout the year. Brian, thank you so much for giving us some time.
Yep. Glad you're here. Thanks, Paul.
Enjoy the rest of the show.
Peace.